Yaskawa.
You are watching the PLC Open Part 4 Coordinated Motion video tutorial series. This video shows how to load the class project onto the demo. Hi, I'm Matt Pelletier. Here's a quick preview of what we'll do in this video. First, open the class project in MotionWorks IEC, and we'll overview the project features. Then I'll show you a little bit of the hardware configuration, and once you have access to a demo, you can go online and save this configuration to the controller and servos. Then you can run the project and test out the basic functionality, such as jogging and setting zero. While these steps are not specifically related to PLC Open Part 4, using this project will quickly get the demo system operational so that you can follow along in the upcoming videos of this tutorial series. So I invite you to start up MotionWorks IEC 3 and follow along. Now you do need to have MotionWorks IEC 3 Pro version 3.2 or higher. You can download this software at yaskawa.com/IECSW and use the latest release of MotionWorks IEC version 3 for up to 30 days for free. And then we need to open up the class project. The project is called PLC 04 Training. You can find the project on yaskawa.com by searching for this name. You can unzip that. And here we typically press no to choose the folder where you'll unzip it to and navigate to wherever you'd like to save it and save. You can click no to the data type overwrite prompt if you get that. And I'll just start with a quick tour of this project. This is virtually the same near default project as used in the PLC Open Basics training. However, it's been modified for the MP3300 IEC and Sigma 7 demo hardware. The older MP2300 IEC controllers do support PLC Open Part 4, but for these videos, we'll use the MP3300 IEC. Okay, under libraries, the YMotion firmware library has been added, and it does have the latest toolbox libraries that you would get when you start a new project with version 3.2. There's nothing in the data types folder, and under logical POUs, we have some various functionality for single axes running in the tasks here. Under global variables, you can see we have the axes here where the data type normally is axis ref. We've changed that to axis struct for both the x-axis and the y-axis to fit the project. And each of these variables has been initialized with some multi-element variable initialization. Now from here, let's move to the hardware configuration. And this one's set up here under Mechatrolink 3 to have three axes, the three axes found in the demo. We'll be focusing on using just the X and Y axis for this gantry system that we're simulating. And the gantry has not yet been configured. That will be the next video where we'll show you how to add the gantry as a group. We also have a few virtual axes. And for each of these axes, we have done very little configuration. We've just set the feed constant to 360. That's 360 units, which are set to millimeters in this linear system. And that will just make it easier for us to visualize where each of the axes will be. Now, a couple other changes here under I/O. We do have the over travels both set to off. And under all parameters, you can see that we have a parameter selection here to apply single phase power. That's just for this demo to operate properly. And the other axis is configured the same way. So for this next part now, we'll need to connect to the controller. If you would like remote access to an MP3300 IEC and Sigma 7 demo, please request by email to training@yaskawa.com. You can see how this works in the remote connection e-learning video. So I've established a connection here to my controller, and you should verify that you're running firmware version 3.2 or higher. Here's the live feed of the MP3300 IEC and Sigma 7 demo. We've got the dual axis amplifier running these two motors we're calling X and Y. And the single axis amplifier runs the motor on the right, axis Z, which we're not using. We're also not using the VPA IO module. And both of the servos are networked over Mechatrolink 3 to the MP3300 IEC controller. The dual axis amplifier is set for network nodes 3 and 4, while the single axis amplifier is set as node 5. All right, so now from within hardware configuration, you'll need to set your IP address to whatever you have for your controller and simply connect to go online. And you're likely to see some configuration differences here. The most important thing that you do is just use the offline configuration. And that's going to send both the amplifier parameters and the configuration. So it's important to do it this way. Now all we need to do is save while you're online. And when that completes, just follow the directions here of cycling power. Just click OK, and then you can go to online reboot controller and wait for that to complete. Now the controller is rebooted, and I can even see the ready light is on. So we can close the hardware configuration and go back to MotionWorks IEC and make this project. You expect to have zero errors since we've not changed anything in the project. Let's go to download this through the project control dialog. And for this controller, you might want to click the More button first. And during development, I tend to just save some time by unchecking Permanent as Boot Project and Include Sources. It does mean that if you reboot the controller, you'll have to download again. That's about it. So set those options however you want, close it, and then click download. And you may see a message that a warm start's not possible. So for this first time, we'll do a cold start, stop, and then a warm start, because we do have to be sure that all the variables initialize and that the start initialize program does run. Okay, we can close this resource, go to debug mode, close these variables, and the POU you'll use the most here is the HMI POU. Scroll to the top there. This is where you can enable the X and Y axis. And the easiest way to do that is to go to the online menu and choose toggle Boolean values. Now I'll adjust my window so I can see the demo off to the side. And click to turn on servos X. That's confirmed by the amplifier front panel display. And Y. Down to rung 6. And click to jog X forward. Click to stop and click to jog reverse. And I'll back it up so the zero mark is about at the middle. And now the same for the Y axis. Down in the watch tab, you can see the actual position. And although the servos are at position 0, the feedback position is not at 0. So scroll down to rung 13, and we'll click to set the zero point. And now the actual positions are 0. And this is the basic operation of the class project. Thank you for watching this video, and remember you can always go to yaskawa.com/IEC as a starting point for everything related to the MPIEC product line and MotionWorks IEC.